For many, grocery shopping is about as mundane as it gets, especially after a long day at the office. But if you walk into a Trader Joe's, somehow that dreaded chore becomes an exhilarating treasure hunt. The aisles and shelves are filled with a bounty of unique edible goodies and potent potables, and there's always something new to try around the next corner. Love Trader Joe's or not, it's hard to deny they have a winning formula. I'll admit that I'm a big fan of Trader Joe's and have been for many years, but I couldn't quite pin down what keeps me coming back 20 years later. So why are people like me nuts for Trader Joe's? And what makes Trader Joe's possibly the best grocery store in the world, despite not having the largest selection or even the lowest prices? As my research and soul search reveals, there is a multitude of surprising aspects all working together to provide not just a service, but foster a very loyal, almost cult-like following. And don't worry, we will have some of that random trivia goodness at the end. Back in 1958, Joe Coulomb opened Pronto Market convenience stores in LA, and later in 1967 they became Trader Joe's. The original store is still open in Pasadena, California. Trader Joe's now has over 500 stores across more than 40 states and is actually part of German parent company Aldi, but is privately held, has no debt, and is self-funding. Oh, and revenue was estimated to be over $13 billion back in 2017. Not too shabby. In its 50 plus year history, there have only been three CEOs: Joe Coulomb, the original Joe, John Shields, and the current CEO, Dan Bain. And even though Joe sold the chain to the Albrecht family back in 1979, they don't interfere in the business and are said to just visit once a year to check in and say hi. There is no corporate budgeting. Every store manager treats their store as if it were their own decentralized business and set their own targets, not something handed down from corporate. And the largest marketing expense? If you said printing and mailing those fearless flyers, you'd be wrong. It's actually letting people try the food at their in-store sample kitchens. And they target opening no more than about a dozen or two stores a year in the US, but only if they can find the right captain and mates to run it, which are sometimes in short supply. They live by the Kaizen philosophy, which is continuous improvement, and in their words, try to do just a little better every year. Being privately held allows them to roll with all these unconventional methods instead of trying to please shareholders. Did you know that almost every employee at Trader Joe's can run a cash register, restock shelves, or answer questions from customers? And they usually do so with a smile. Crew members will even walk you over to something you can't find. And this is no accident. This is just one benefit when you pay your employees more. Store managers can make in the six figures, and full-time employees start out at about half that. Not bad for retail. Trader Joe's also contributes about 15% of their employees' gross salary to a tax-deferred retirement account. Remember those? Yeah, me neither. Trader Joe's actually has three important parts to their hiring process. They seek out people who love people, they offer excellent pay and benefits, and they instill their own cultural values during training. You treat your employees right, and they'll treat your customers right. Walking into a Trader Joe's is not like a normal grocery store. It might feel small. Employees will be dressed casually, some in Hawaiian shirts. There will likely be a sample kitchen in full swing with free fresh food and hot coffee. There will be bustle and lines that move quickly. Bells may ring from time to time, and you won't be able to escape the tiki/nautical/island theme. And they always seem to have new products coming in, and of course, all the seasonal products like pumpkin, gingerbread, hot cocoa, and peppermint flavored items during fall and winter. In a word, it's fun. You invite your customers to participate in the fun, and they'll come back on their own. Trader Joe's respects the customer in a few ways. For one thing, there are never coupons, sales, or club cards to worry about. And that also means your data is kept with you, not shared or sold like so many companies do today. Although so-called trading hours vary from location to location, many Trader Joe's are generally open from 9 a.m. to 9 p.m. every day of the year but Christmas. And since upwards of 90% of the items in the store are Trader Joe's branded, they have greater control over the entire experience, from ingredients to packaging and freshness and finally the flavor. That means that none of the Trader Joe's branded items contain high fructose corn syrup or genetically modified ingredients, and usually things you can pronounce. They also shun antibiotics, artificial flavors, colorings, and preservatives, as well as offering a fair number of gluten-free, vegetarian, kosher, and vegan choices. And everything they sell must pass a taste test by Trader Joe's crew members. I like that. So earlier we mentioned that typically Trader Joe's does not have the lowest prices or the widest selection, but what you do often get is a very fair price for items of high quality and a very curated selection at that. Which means every item needs its own story and something unique in ingredients, flavor, origin, or production method, usually debuted in the Fearless Flyer. Trader Joe's has somewhere around 5,000 items versus 40,000 at a typical grocery store, and their stores are proportionally smaller. About 12,000 square feet versus 50,000, and yet Trader Joe's has one of the highest sales per square feet in the grocery industry. And it makes sense because sometimes too much choice actually causes decision paralysis, resulting in shoppers actually spending less because they are afraid of making the wrong choice. Less really is more in this case. So what are the best things to buy and not buy? Here are some shopping tips from an old salt. I find things like bread, milk, eggs, canned tuna, beans, and other staples are pretty reasonable. They also have a very wide cheese, wine, and beer selection, often at decent prices. However, some of the raw meat selections and produce tend to be on the expensive side, so be careful here. Trader Joe's won't always be a true one-stop shop. For instance, if you need that special fresh exotic herb, baby food, or a 5-gallon bucket of potato salad, you may need to go elsewhere. But in many cases, you can get all your shopping done in a single trip. And although it might cost a little more, it also means you don't have to spend time going to a second store. So to me, what makes Trader Joe's the best grocery store in the world is their ethical business practices and staying privately held, fair treatment of their employees and in turn the customer, the walk-in experience which just shouts fun, the fact that they have a real sense of humor and don't take themselves too seriously, never trying to gouge the customer in favor of big profits, the respect they have for their customer not only when they enter, but also when they leave by not collecting data, and the ability to make opening and consuming every item feel like a special experience. But before we talk about all the random trivia goodness, I just wanted to take a brief moment to let you know another way you can support my efforts. I put dozens of hours into researching, writing, and editing every single video, and of course, your YouTube subscription is always appreciated. But if you want to become a superstar and help me create more frequent content, consider becoming a patron. Thank you so much. So now on to some random trivia. As part of the gift-giving tradition of Japan called omiyage, Trader Joe's has become quite popular. Apparently, Japanese love receiving things like Trader Joe's cookies or coffee beans because they are apparently cute and the packaging looks very American. But the fabric reusable shopping bags appear to be quite the phenomenon. And if you can get a Trader Joe's bag that is unique to the city you are visiting, like a bag with a skyline of New York, for example, extra bonus points for you. Did you know that a Trader Joe's employee will open just about anything for you to taste test gratis? Pretty cool to try the food before you buy it. And I have to think the crew members love macking down on that leftover bag of goodies after you leave. What's with the bells? Well, one bell means another register needs to be open, two bells means there are additional questions that need to be answered at checkout, and three bells summons a manager. Now, we all know that Trader Joe's name is on most products in the store, but Italian products are often named Trader Giotto's, and Mexican or Spanish items named Trader Jose's. Fun little thing to look for. Trader Joe's is known to be very secretive. Why? Because it doesn't want anyone to know who's making its products. It's a competitive advantage, and in many cases, suppliers feel the same way, since they sometimes cut Trader Joe's a better deal on the same product than they do other customers. Have you ever noticed the artwork on the walls? Every store has its own crew members that create artwork to represent the surrounding neighborhood or town. Something cool to watch for next time you're visiting. Some store locations have their own Find the Mascot game where kids can obtain a prize when they tell a crew member where it is hiding. Ask a crew member, as a parent, next time you are there for details. Ever hear of Pirate Joe's? I hadn't either, but it was a Canadian store that resold Trader Joe's products since Trader Joe's has no presence in Canada. Trader Joe's sued the founder, and although the original suit was dismissed, Trader Joe's reopened it on appeal, and Pirate Joe's eventually had to be shuttered due to increasing legal defense costs. The links people will go to get Trader Joe's products. Amazing. A podcast? That's right, Trader Joe's now has a podcast, and I have to say it is oddly fascinating. But then again, I am nerdy enough to make a video about Trader Joe's. Check it out if you want. It's pretty good stuff. So that wraps up why I think Trader Joe's might just be the best grocery store in the world. What do you think about Trader Joe's? Anything I missed? And what is your favorite grocery store? Also, tell me what other video topics you might like to see on companies, history, food, or anything else really, and I'll consider it. This is 2-Bit History. Thank you for watching.